Now I will discuss the same thing with a heavy pulley. Now this is a heavy pulley. I have taken this one as heavy pulley with its radius taken to be R, and now two blocks of mass M1 and M2 are suspended by the use of a light string. This is of mass M1, this is of mass M2. Now this is the string passing over the groove of this heavy pulley. This time this is a heavy pulley with rough surface. This is a heavy pulley with rough surface. Okay?
Yeah.
R is the radius of that cross section of the pulley, because pulley is geometrically a disc, circular disc, solid disc. Okay, why we are considering the term radius here, what we didn't do in the previous case? The reason behind this is, in this time we will consider the rotation of the pulley along with the vertically upward and downward motion of the blocks available in this arrangement. Okay, I'll explain you now. Now, as this heavy pulley is having its rough surface of contact with the string, and if we again consider the case where M1 is taken to be heavier mass than M2, if M1 is taken as heavier mass than M2, then obviously the free body diagram can be shown this way. M1 is having its weight M1g acting downward. M2 is having its weight M2g acting downward. Now see, the string used is definitely the light string. String used here is again a light string, but this time the string will be used having different tension on either side of the pulley. In the previous arrangement, we considered same strength on both sides of the string. On either side of the pulley, the string portion had same strength, but now the string portions will not have same strength. Why? Because, see, if I consider M1 is going downward, being heavier, and M2 is moving upward with the same acceleration, then this says that if I identify the, suppose this point is identified as A, this point is B, this point is C, and this point is D. Got my point? So portion of the string CD, portion of the string, CD portion should increase, whereas AB portion should decrease. Isn't it or not? If these are the motion of M1 and M2, if M1 is moving downward and correspondingly M2 is moving upward, then obviously the portion of the string from C to D should increase and the portion of the string from A to B must decrease. Do you agree with me or not?
Yes,
fine. Whereas this much portion, now see, do you think this much portion of the string will change? So far as the contact of the string is concerned with the pulley surface, that should remain always unchanged. But the fact is, if CD portion increases and AB portion decreases, that means string is moving definitely clockwise in order in contact with the pulley. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
If the if the string is moving clockwise in the order, then only we can make this argument possible. Yes, CD portion will increase and AB portion will decrease. So these two movements will allow the string to move clockwise, remaining in contact with the pulley. Clear? So we can write down, this implies that the portion of the string, we can write down the portion of the string in contact with the pulley surface must move clockwise in order. So that CD length increases and AB decreases. Do you agree? As AB portion decreases with the upward movement of M2, correspondingly CD portion increases with the downward movement of M1. That is only possible when the string with the pulley surface in contact, the portion of the string in contact with the pulley surface must have a clockwise order in motion, isn't it? Okay, fine. If you think that a string will move clockwise, but we are considering the nature of the surface of the pulley as rough surface, isn't it? Nature of the pulley surface is being rough surface. How can we expect the pulley surface will allow the string to move on the rough surface as freely? Do you think that? Is it possible that on a rough surface the string will contact freely on the rough surface of the pulley? Never possible. That means the pulley surface will definitely try to resist the clockwise movement of the string. And on the other side, the contrary says that string has to move clockwise, otherwise it cannot support the vertical movement of M1 and M2. This shows that yes, it has to be, there is a clockwise movement of the string on pulley surface, but that cannot be possible simply as a free movement on the rough surface. Rather, the actual thing that will take place, that string will move clockwise along with the pulley taking also in clockwise rotation. Got my point? That means we can focus on the important point that here both string and pulley, both string and pulley will rotate clockwise in order. For supporting vertical motion of M1 and M2. Could you follow what I mean? The vertical motion on M1 and M2 can only be supported. The vertical motion of M1 and M2 can only be supported.